Hey guys, welcome back to Mean Figurines. I'm your host Cindy, and today we're gonna continue on with painting my D.Va mech. Last week we added the white to this thigh piece, and now I'm gonna do some touch up around the edges for the gray that I added on the week prior. And then we're gonna add some other colors, or I might just move on to the other pieces and then wait for that color. I'm just so excited to get this kind of like completely painted. It's very smooth. I'm not sure if you guys can see on my little close-up camera. I do have a little bit of a mess on my desk because I'm putting together my airbrush and kind of adding some lube to it. From this, I'm using this needle juice. Just to kind of lubricate my airbrush. It was a recommended product that I found online. But anyways, so you can see how smooth the paint job. And this is why I just can never go back to just brushing again. It's just the benefits outweigh the tediousness of it, I guess. Yeah, so I'm just going to put my gun together. And notice this piece here, I left it in my container with the whatchamacallit. Oh, this is with my airbrushing cleaner, and it's kind of rusting a little bit, so I added the little lube there. I'm trying to get some of this pink gunk out. Should try to get this area as clean as possible. I can scrape that down. Yeah, so I'm gonna put this gun together. Oop, need to hydrate. Okay, so what's this? Yeah, just putting the gun together. Sometimes I forget, like, what's all the pieces I have here. This gun's a little different when putting it together. So I'm just gonna put the, this connector parts together first. This is the head of it. Oh, this is the back. Go ahead. And I think I figured out how to finally work this gun. This gun's a little different from my other guns in terms of assembly and how the flow comes out of the paint flow settings, it seems. So I'm going to, I think I could tighten this. I might have to tighten this a little bit. Oh yeah, oh, I almost forgot. The needle. And this one, I think it's this one. Yep. Is it this one? Nope, wrong. This one. So I saw a YouTube video. So I'm gonna add some, he said just to add a drop of it onto this needle thingy. Whoops. So like half a drop. And so it's just right there like so. I'm using a microfiber cloth. I bought a bunch of these as a experiment for clipping my my pieces. Where else could I put it? Maybe I should put him in here. Maybe just a little bit. Like, oh yeah, oiling your parts. Yeah, much better. Put some on the side too. So I don't think I'm going to leave this gun overnight with the airbrush cleaner. So I'll take this off right now. We'll drive this thing down. Take that one through. Yep, that's through. Alright. Put this one in. Here it is. For this gun, I believe this could actually control the now the valve. So yeah, I still probably have to tighten that one and then control here. And then put this piece in. Oopsie. Yeah, this is the most complicated hairbrush gun to put together. Always, for some reason, always ends that way. See. So I'm just gonna round this out. Okay. Go here. I love these caps. They just kind of like just connect on. You don't have to screw it. Got hair in my mouth. Okay, so I'll save the lube for the next one. So this piece, how do I put the handle back on? Yeah, this one. Oh, I have to put this in. Like so. This nut in. There you go. So yeah, so today, what was I going to do? Oh yeah, I was gonna touch up my my thigh piece, this piece right here I'm talking about. Try to get into the camera. This piece. I'm gonna touch that up with the grays here. I'm still having trouble with fine lines, but hopefully with good practice I'll get pro at this. I need to find a more efficient way of just swapping colors besides the gun, because like you have to clean it thorough in case you don't want another color mixed with your paint. So I need to continue to watch more YouTube videos and people airbrushing to get this down. Okay, so see right here my trigger is really tight, so I'm going to try to loosen it. There, it's this knob here that loosens it, looks like. Yeah, perfect. Alright, now I got the gun loosened. And then I'll figure out the paint flow. I think this is the paint flow. And then this nozzle is the airflow, or the trigger, at least, trigger release. Okay, so enough of that. Next piece, next gun I mean. Oh, so I do want to try this gun out. I have not opened it yet. The only thing I'm reluctant to do is because it uses a pile. Oh, I could probably clean that, it shouldn't be a problem. Yeah, so I might use this gun today, hook it up, and if I'm ready to use a third color, I guess, But usually I'm doing two colors since I messed up my other gun, which I should get a replacement. I've kind of been on the fence on it. Do I really need a third gun and want to spend $120 on this precision airbrush? I should do reviews on these products, by the way. Yeah. But anyways, so this gun is kind of loaded. Let me just make sure it has airflow. No airflow. Oh, that's probably why, because it wasn't tightly in. Okay. Oh! Yeah, it just sprayed my new water, so. That's a white residue in there. It's a good thing I blasted the stuff out right now. Okay, cool. Whoops. Instead of clicking my mouse here, my keyboard. My desk is a mess. My tools. Okay. So that works. Good, good, good. Alright, I'm gonna put this guy in this box away. I think I wanna make take a trip to the art store tomorrow. If I can just get out of bed. I just like sleeping so much. That's why I was gone a little late today. Well, this is actually kind of early, but I was gonna hop on at 3 p.m. my time, which was 2 hours ago, but I felt like taking a nap, and I took an hour nap, and then I was like, oh, I need another hour, and so I feel like I'm pretty rested. If I had a Red Bull, I'd be like up playing, doing this all night probably. Okay, so what I'm going to do here. I'm going to assemble this just like how the YouTube guide. Cool. What's this piece? Oh, it's from down there. Okay, cool, cool. It's like when you have extra pieces sitting around, you kind of like wonder, like, uh oh, did you mess up? So this little piece goes. Oh, the guy did say to put oil. Lubricant on this thing. I'm gonna do that. I'm not sure if I got that. Maybe I just go from the same. Ooh, that's too much. Too much right there. This one's a little tricky to get in sometimes. I have to be at the right angle for it. Yeah, I wish, I guess airbrush manufacturers had it where you could just turn maybe this piece out, and then so you could just wash or soak this in airbrush fluid. Airbrush cleaning fluid. There you go. And yeah, so you don't have to put the whole gun. I guess it's just a quarter of it. Right now I have like 2/3 of it. Okay. I'm gonna put this guy in. Yeah, I'm getting better and better at putting these guns together. Okay. the next thing is, next thing I'm just gonna put this piece in front of this piece. Helps protect my needle. Put that in. Oops. And all right, I'm gonna add another drop of oil or lubricant on this needle. Ooh, I have to like angle it so it just flows down, not off. And just a little bit onto this needle. I feel like I can still see the tip of it. It's white. Had like some paint still on it, but should be okay, I think. Put this in, trip this down. Oh, it's stuck on something. Alright, got it. It's kind of alright. That's in. Alright, put this guy in. Yeah, definitely well worth. It does look like a lot of maintenance, but I like this over just having to wash my brushes all the time, and then my brushes get all worn out. You can see these are cheapy brushes, so they get worn out pretty quick after one use. And even, and maybe I'm just not washing my brushes well, the right way, I guess. But I just love airbrushing since I started. Just gonna mess around with that. Now I'll just adjust the setting, the nozzles, as I need to. Plug this in. So this is the bottom of it. Okay, plug this in. I'm gonna seal up my lubricant. Oh, there you go. Then I'm gonna test the airflow in this one. Yep, everything's good. Alright. This is all done. Put this away. Yeah, I wanna probably hit up the Glendale art store. It's a very big art store in Glendale, north. Kind of like Glendale is like near Pasadena. And I have been there for years since I've done art school. But they have a lot of artsy stuff that, like just containers and things I want to do to help me organize my setup here. It's like a complete mess. So I want to get that going. Okay. So, anyways. As I was talking about, let me prep my table because right now, so I have this white area here, and it's the overspray of the airbrush. I can feel it's kind of rough here. I think I'm just going to add another sheet of paper, and just so that I have a smooth surface to work with. And I'm just using standard copy paper, or it's a little premium copy paper because it was just a scratch paper from my old projects, the school projects, long time ago. I just kept around because it was pretty good paper. And what is this? Just to cover it. And then I'm probably going to replace this bigger piece sometime, maybe in the near future. Sometime soon, after I get a good use of it. Just kind of leave that for now. So I have a nice clean space. My stuff together. Okay. All right. So first thing I want to do today is work on I'm going to draw in my my white line, and then I'm going to draw in the gray again. Yeah. White first, because white, it just takes longer, it's harder to cover the gray. So, where is, oh, here's my flat white. And I'm just gonna use a small, one of my small brushes for this one. One of my favorite small brushes is this one. It's a good clean edge. Okay, oh, I forgot to mix this. Hold on 1 second. Put this on my mixer. I think I have enough for, if I'm gonna paint more white. I do need to paint more white on my, on the ears for this piece. What am I doing? Yeah, white. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna move the camera over here so you guys can get the front of it as I paint. So what I'm trying to do is get a clean line going. Oh, it's kind of blurry, no? Okay. I'm trying my best to draw a straight line. The best I can. Okay. This is a lot harder than I thought, I think. I try not to use too much paint, as it like it tends to run when I used my airbrush mix. see her? Let me see me look here a little bit. Okay. Get some more paint. Right? Okay. Okay, yeah, so I'm gonna come back and I'm gonna turn off my airbrush, but my pump, it's airbrush. So I'm gonna come back here, let it dry a little bit, come back and add another coat on the edge here. And then just touch up here. I'm not going to bother with this area because it's going to get covered by the joint piece. But this other side, these two areas, you will probably see if you take a closer look. And I do see I need a touch up here on the gray, so I'm gonna come back with the gray too as I finish up with the white. Oh, that's weird. Okay, so I notice my line is not straight. Well, it's not as, when I'm looking at this angle, it does not as clean. Yeah, I'm just gonna have to come back and worry about that. So this, I guess, just gotta be careful. I'm not gonna touch any of the paint, wet paint. Okay. Oh, hey! How's it going, Tino's Slim? Welcome to the channel. Yeah, I'm, in case you're wondering what I'm doing, I'm painting a 3D printed D.Va mech from Overwatch game. So, I do a lot of 3D printing, painting, collecting action figures. So I've been trying, Yes, I did. I can show you more of the pieces, they're over here. This is just, not all of it. I have a lot more. I can't get my camera over there. Sorry, it's kind of snagged against something. But yeah, I have, I'm not sure if you know D.Va. Oh, I must show you my Instagram. I have a picture of my D.Va on there. Oh yeah, I recommend it. I do recommend a resin 3D printer if you have a garage to print in, because they do create a lot of fumes and it's very toxic, but the result from a 3D printer, a resin 3D printer, is so much far better than your standard filament printer. But let me just show you real quick. I did a, you kind of can see a comparison. Sorry, these are my action figures that I bought. But I do have a D.Va mech. Here she is. This is this was done maybe about 5 months ago. Not the figure, but the mech itself. I 3D printed and painted. Took me about five six months to paint, but most of it was done with a filament printer. You can see the lines on the model. In some pieces, I actually did with a resin printer. I think the guns were done in the resin printer. That's why it's a lot smoother. But you can see the lines on the filament printer. Even though there's a lot of sanding. But you'll get your model, but for the look, I'm more into like the smoother, you know, less sanding work. And so what I'm doing here is I'm making a bigger version. So when this was kind of like my test print and painting, and might as well, since I printed almost all the pieces, I ended up printing everything and then just painting it, because I don't really paint as much, so I was just learning how to paint. And this is all the pieces, all painted and done. You can see here's how it looks right after, well, not right after the 3D print. This is after sanding. Weeks of sanding, lots of sanding, and it's still so hard to get the lines out. I learned that if you use a filler primer, that might help, but still a lot more sanding. The gray pieces are printed with the resin printer, and yeah, the pink is the filament. And then, oops, that's my comic book. Yeah, I also do. I've been trying to make a comic book, action comic book, as well, without my action figures. And you can see all my action figures on my Instagram, meanfigurines. I mean, I actually have more. I've been cataloging my action figures and posting one figure a day. I have over 1,000 figures. Oh, this is another 3D print project I did. This is a trophy that a co-worker commissioned me to make, and it's just I modeled the base and the nameplate, and 3D printed, painted this and everything. Here's how it looked and stuff. Yeah, that's my resin 3D printer, not the big one, so that's why I could do like bigger projects and stuff. But yeah, that's mostly what I do these days, is 3D print and paint. So right now my current project is this D.Va mech. I do want to start working on a dollhouse, actually getting into that. I've been seeing a lot of Facebook groups and Instagram groups doing dollhouses, and I'm really interested in doing little miniature stuff. And because my end goal is I want to build a city for my action figures. So, I feel like I'm not doing a really good job creating these lines here. How did I get that? I might have to go back with the gray and touch this up just a little bit more too. So yeah, so I'm doing the white first, and then if I need to add more gray, I'll just go cover the white. Because it's a lot easier that way. And this area here, I think I could use more white. Come up a little bit more with the white piece. What's a good beginner 3D printer? Oh, so do you want filament or do you want resin? Oh, so I think for a budget 3D printer, I hear Creality 3D printers are pretty good. You can get one for like $200. And you have to do some form of assembly. But yeah, that can get you started for $200. If you're gonna go with resin, I would go with AnyCubic. They have pretty cheap resin printers. They'll run you under $300. And then you don't have to model your piece. You can find a lot of 3D models online, especially a Thingiverse. This model I actually bought from a site called Gambody. And they make really, really good high-end models, detailed models, and they have like articulation and all that stuff. That's when you have like a really, like a higher-end printer, then you want to, you know, print something like that with the parts and stuff. Having to print with a filament, like movable parts, it's a little clunky, I think, especially when you have to have precision involved. The filament printer, if you don't sand it properly, think parts won't fit correctly. So it's a lot of work. So even with this resin printer, I had to sand down a lot just to get it to make sure things fit right. I'm gonna have to switch to a smaller brush because this brush, I'm not getting into the corner I want right here. So yeah, if you want to print bigger items, I mean, a nice printer is like the MakerBots. They're very easy to use, but they cost so much. So that's why I'm kind of like, you're spending like $2,000 for a printer. And if you, this is just a beginner, that's why I recommend like any of the Creality printers, just to kind of get your feet wet. And then once you feel more confident about printing, then you can start getting the better ones. Yeah, you can see my brush strokes here, but oh well, I'm going to have to deal with it. Yeah, another downside about resin printing, it's very messy. After you print, you have to wash your prints in an alcohol bath. So I have like a whole table set up just to wash my 3D prints. And then after you wash it, you need to cure it in UV light or keep it out in the sun. And I built a little light box with UV light to cure it, so I could just cure it overnight. And so there, that's why, like, if you get into resin printing, a garage is necessary. Trying my best here to just create nice smooth lines where I missed with my airbrush. Okay. So, what part of the world are you from? U.S. What part of U.S.? If you don't mind me asking. San Diego? Or is it South Dakota? Yeah, because when I think of SD, oh, South Dakota. Oh, okay, cool. I'm from California, so that's why when I hear SD, that's our short for San Diego. Hey, Adrina, I can't say that word. Adrina? Adrina, right? Beyond red. Oh, what's that mean? Ah, thanks for the follow. What's the Beyond red? What is it to do in South Dakota? I don't hear much from that state. Or besides like fracking, I think, right? South Dakota, a lot of fracking. Aww, at least like a scenery. Despair. Aww, that's beautiful. At least you don't have traffic. Oh, sorry, my hand's cramping up here, trying to get into this corner here. Yeah, if you ever come to LA, deal with the traffic here, you'll miss South Dakota. My wrist is cramping up. It's like, I like get into a weird angle. Okay, so I'm trying to get in here without hitting the top. Just gotta be careful. Do you go to like North Dakota much? I just bought an airbrush. Ooh! I highly recommend it. Yes. I use an airbrush. This is one of my airbrushes. To paint this. You see how smooth it is? It's wonderful. And I use acrylic. So because it's easier to wash. And stuff. I haven't messed around with like oil-based enamels and stuff. I just don't want to deal with that mess. So acrylic, for me, that's the way to go. Oh, so you stream often too? I try to stream every Saturday as much as I can. I used to stream on Sundays, but it was just with work and life balance, it was just hard to keep up. Sometimes. Oh, I see. Well, you're always welcome to hang out and chit-chat and watch me do my paint stuff. Or I just do a lot of random projects and stuff. Sometimes I stream from my room and I give tours of my action figures. Oh, I could just give you a quick preview on my Facebook page real quick. My Facebook has more action figures. I've been cataloging it there. But yeah, if you see my action figures, it keeps on going. So I want to do this for my Instagram page. But I want to paint on canvas with airbrush. Oh. Ooh. I have not tried canvas. For me, I'm having a hard time getting fine lines. But I know you use like stencils and stuff to get that. But yeah, anyways, that was my action figures. Yeah, good luck. What What subjects do you do? Do you do like scenery, landscape stuff, portraits, people, buildings? Oh, hey, DJ. You made it. Oh, I just started painting. I have only 3 paintings so far, but have all been anime. Oh! What anime do you like? I'm into anime too. I've been binge watching Attack on Titan, trying to catch up on that series. DJ is a, how would I call it, DJ? A regular viewer, there you go. He's one of my regulars. I can link the 3 pictures I've done. Oh yeah, sure. I'm always happy to see other people's artwork. Since 2020. Yep, that's when I started streaming. Yeah, I only started streaming during COVID. And painting. I'm new to painting, really. Oh, let me see. Demon Slayer. That's pretty damn good, dude. So you draw too? That's pretty good. I forget the guy's name, but yeah. Oh, Dragon Ball. Dragon Ball is one of the animes I don't watch, or I'm not a big fan of. Ah, Goku. Why do you know Goku? Ah, that's a good Goku. Yeah, good stuff there. Yeah, you're pretty good. Yeah, you'll love airbrushing. You can get like fades, ingredients and stuff. Once you get the hang of it. I don't know how to do that yet, so. Okay. Now I can go back to the earlier side I started. I might stream. We'll see. Oh, nice. Are you on vacation or something? Just adding another coat of white here just to try to cover the gray. Well, I can see. I miss a spot here. Try to get in here. This one's hard. I think I got it. I'll get it again on the next round. Oh, I totally forgot. I need to get on this side too. I got the top part, but I didn't get the bottom here. Yeah. Make sure. I want to connect this somehow. Let's draw this line up. My paintbrush is very wet right now. Okay, so I want to bring this line up, but make it scared, because I'm not going to do this right. It's just a small, thin line. I'm not sure how I'm going to get in there. Oh, three off in a row. I see. I'm having a three-day weekend next week, too, but I'm going to the doctors and stuff. Oops, sorry, it's kind of blurry right now. Oh. Yeah, I've been wanting to take like a week off so I could do more stuff. Yeah, I work 9 to 5 during the week, so it's hard to do things during the week. And especially sometimes I'll do overtime. I work late, and sometimes when you just want to go, if you work so much, you just want to go home and just watch TV and relax. So I just watch anime or some TV show. Been watching like Star Trek, Discovery, a bunch of sci-fi stuff. As you can see in my collection, like I'm into a lot of things. I like a lot of stuff. Is that a good show? Star Trek? Discovery? I really like it. Things start really taking off season 2. Oh, yeah, it's very good. And then there was Picard. So if you like The Next Generation, there's right now season 2 is airing. Picard's a good series. I just love the science behind Star Trek. It's just very interesting. I wish we as a human race can actually get there someday. Okay. Ooh, I don't know how I'm gonna do this right. Let's see. So I noticed I can get in this crack here. Do that with this brush. What I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna paint upward like this. Yes, I'm painting into an area that I should not be painting. But I'll go back and touch it up with the gray just so that I get this white piece connected here. Trying to get in there. Yeah, I'm gonna come back with the gray and touch it up some more. So now I got that area. Oh, oops, let me get this area right here. I'll come back and do get that. Yeah, I just don't like how my brush strokes are. It's just bobby. Oh, wait, hold on. I haven't watched Star Trek. So many Star Trek shows. The Mad Men. When will they stop? Mad Men. Oh, that show? I've never watched Mad Men. I don't think I've watched that. But yeah, some of the Star Treks, like Discovery, no, not Discovery, Voyager was interesting. I never watched all of it. Some of the Star Treks, I'll watch the first episode and I'll watch the last episodes. Kind of give me an idea of the characters and what happened in that series. Something's burning. Give me 1 minute. I'm gonna go check my kitchen. Usually my mom's like cooking and she'll leave the stove open. I'll be right back. I smell. I'll be right back. Well, it's not my mom. Good, thank goodness. It might be my neighbor cooking something. It scares me because my room is next to the kitchen. And when my mom leaves the stove on, she forgets about it. My room will be the first room after the kitchen that gets burnt down. And all my action figures will get all crispy. So have to make sure she's not doing that again. Oh yeah. Well, yeah, thanks for tuning in and thanks for the follow. Yeah, I hope to see you around on Saturdays. Good luck with your painting and airbrushing. Take care. Be safe. So I'm doing the second round of paint, brushing on this just to cover the gray. It's looking pretty good. Then I'm gonna come back with the gray and do some touch up. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that burning smell bothers me. Oh, you know what? Maybe it's my neighbor. Because their house kind of caught on fire a couple months ago. I gotta double check. Okay, I'm back. Somebody must be doing a barbecue or something. I hope it's a barbecue. Back support. Okay. Back to meeting. Pretty good here. I'm not too happy how this came out up here. So I'm gonna go over it again. Still kind of wet, actually. I think I added too much paint here. Oh no. Smudged it. Yeah, I got the top. I need to wipe down my brush. Oh no. The top of my brush hit that, and now I have to touch that up now. The gray. So I'm gonna go back here on this side now. Get the ink. Just adding another coat. Okay, we'll see. Yeah, I'll have to come back with the gray and touch that up. Getting little scuffs on here. My hands have paint on it or something. Okay, I'm gonna come back in here. Add another coat. Some more white over here. I'm always seeing like spots I miss at certain, at different angles. A little bit too much paint in there, but it's okay, I can fix that. Okay, I think I got the white on. I'm gonna put this aside. So what I'm gonna do while I let that dry, oops, forgot to put my saran wrap in here. While I let that paint dry, just make a new one. I'm gonna start masking my other pieces before I start laying in the gray. I think I have like one or two more pieces to mask. Okay. So yeah, last week I think I did the pink, redid the pink here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to mask the pink pieces. And I'm probably going to add the white first here. And then I'll shoot the gray. Oh no, well, I'm going to do gray. Cool. I definitely, okay. So white and gray again is the two colors I'm gonna paint today. So I'm gonna do, yeah, I'm gonna do the white first here and then come back with the gray all over this. That's what I'm going to do. So yeah, first mask this. I got another follow. Thank you, Doja. Sorry, I missed it. Missed the follow. Because I don't hear the follows come up on my screen. So if you're still watching, thank you. So what I really want to do is, oops, paper towels fell. Yeah. So what I really want to do is try to get in here somehow. I might just use a wash or some sort to get in there. Or a gray. I don't think I can get a gray in there. Actually, that's what I'll do. I'm going to mask this. Piece, put the gray down because then I'll have gray in here. I'll mask it a little bit more and then I'll shoot the white on. That might work. Okay. Let's see. Let's start here. So this one I'm just gonna try to press down on it and then I'm gonna come back and mold it. I just want to make sure it sticks onto the surface so then I don't get any paint bleed underneath the mask as much as possible. So all I want is the surface of this to be pink. Keep it pink. And then the rest will work out. So I might have too much. So I'm just going to try to trim it just a little bit. I can always add more if I need to. And I just want to press it down. And I'll mold it. Okay. So I'm going to start the inside first. I think the inside meaning like this part down here, because I feel like if I start, I want to get that crisp first, and then I can get the outside, which is a little bit easier out here on the edges. Oi! Welcome back, DJ! Where did you go? I met one of my cousins I never met. Oh, that's awesome. Where are they from? So I'm just using a clay sculpting tool to kind of mold my my museum putty around. Wow. What part of the family, from your dad's side or your mom's side? Cool. Did your cousin like PS5? Did you show him your PS5? Oh, you should show them, if they like gaming, of course. Oh, that's nice. I love Grand Canyon. It was really nice to go. Oh, there's some stuff that's stuck in here. I see. Well, it must be fun catching up with your cousins or meeting them. Yeah, masking is the most tedious part of airbrushing. Okay. I forgot something. Well, actually, I did forget to touch up the pink on that other piece I was working on. I'll come back and do that when I finish this up. I want to let the white paint dry first. And then come back with many more touch-ups if I need to. Oh, nice, nice. Wait, but I thought you didn't know you had a cousin. I met a cousin. Oh, you never met. Okay, okay. Yeah, I have a few cousins, younger cousins, in Australia and New Zealand that I haven't really met. Yeah, as soon as COVID stuff is behind us, I want to take some trips. Almost done with masking this. So since I'm masking the pink, I don't have to use the saran wrap to cover because I'm just gonna go in here, get the gray in there. What happened here? This part's a little hard, this last bit here. Ooh, the music's over. Alright, back to the top of the song. Playlist, I mean. There you go. To get a good clean edge over here. It looks pretty rough. Okay. This is good for the gray. I hope I leave enough gap in here to get the gray in there. Okay, so one down. I feel like this piece needs more pink still. At least another coat. Yeah. Same thing with this piece. Just like in there. A strip in there just to get that gray. I mean pink. And this dark gray, and this is a light gray. Okay, so one more piece. Oh, I should put these. Looks like maybe tonight I'm just going to do masking. I have like at least 6 plus this 7 other pieces to mask before I start spraying down the gray. So I guess this week is going to be kind of boring masking week. And then I'll shoot all the gray next week. Oh, my focus is out of focus. Come on, focus. What's wrong with the camera? Come on, focus. The lens dirty? Sorry. Might be dirty. Clean it real quick. I need like some water or something. You have like speckle of paint on it. That helps. Much better. There. Okay. Oh, I hear a lot of fire engines. something big caught on fire. Okay. I'm hearing a lot of fire engines. There is kind of like a mountain or a hill nearby me with a lot of trees and stuff. So that might have caught on fire again. Sometimes we have idiots shooting off fireworks and stuff. That could have caught on fire. Okay. Let's get this one back. Okay, so get this here. You know, I should look at my little reference before I continue. Let me see. Where is my video? Oops. Commercial. Is it pink? Can't tell. Go up on the legs. Zoom in on the legs. Oh, I know. I have a picture. Well, the backside is gray, but I think it's just the plating. Yeah, that's gray too. Yeah, I think I'm right where I'm at. Let's see. I wish I had another picture. It's the best I have from that angle. actually really want to start painting today, but gotta do this first. I'll take care of this masking first before I paint. That way I don't have to like wash, do a little bit and wash my airbrush constantly. I feel like I did this once much faster, so I'm used to it. Okay, that seems to work. Oh, am I supposed to, I didn't mask this yet. Oh, I have so many more pieces to mask. Oh boy. This one's not too bad though. Yeah, I added, the reason I didn't mask this last week because I added a another pink coat. That's what I did. Okay. Let me do this first before I start on the drink some water. So I have, let me just bring out the pieces I need to mask. So I have these joysticks I need to mask, but what I'm thinking is I might do this another session. Because I want to mask everything but this inside part, because this is a gunmetal color versus the gray. So the gray is going to be outside, but the inside here is gunmetal. So I want to do kind of like work the inside out. So mask all this, paint that, and probably hand brush this the joystick part, and then do the gray, kind of like what I did here, was testing with my masking tape. And I can see like some hard lines here, but then do the gray again. And then I'm not sure how I'm gonna mask this. I might just put putty in here and just touch it up later when I do that. So this might be another session. So I do have the hip piece, which is a bigger piece, like one of the biggest pieces I need to mask. Yeah, this part I might just brush in. Might be easier just to brush it than mask and paint. Maybe we'll see. I like airbrushing. Whoops, I like airbrushing so much that I might just do it. But yeah, definitely gonna mask all this, and so I can get this piece gray. And then I got the other thigh piece. The thigh piece is one of the hardest pieces because it has these crevices in here that I have to get into. So it takes some time. So I'm not sure I'll be able to even mask all these tonight. And then another complicated piece is the two guns pieces. So I guess that they're as complex as the legs, I think. These leg pieces I just did. Whereas I'm just gonna cover it, the plates, the pink part here, and then paint everything else gray. And then slowly come in here and paint. So a bunch of pieces to do actually tonight. What else? And then, I should maybe mask this because, yes, I should. The tip of this, I believe, is gray as well. So I'm going to be masking the majority of this top piece here, get the gray in, and then I believe this part is silver, and this is just white, probably. I have to look at my references. And then getting in here would be very hard to do. This is black, and then this is white. So what I might do is do the white first. Do you think? Yeah, maybe do the white first, and then get the black in there. Yeah, I'll have to figure it out, but we'll figure it. Yeah, I'll do that in a second. Well, not a second, in a couple of minutes, actually. But yeah, let's do this one first, because this is the easiest one of all these complex pieces. I need like a little easy one. Kind of like give me a break a little bit. And then I'll work on the complex ones. So pretty much what I'm trying to do is what I did exactly with this piece. Just put putty all around it. And then I just have saran wrap covering it. Sure, this is good? Yeah, this is good. And then so that way I can paint the gray trim on it. In case you're wondering what I'm using here, it's just museum putty, which I find it works pretty well. It's sticky enough to stick onto the surface, and it has minimal bleeding underneath. As long as you press down in certain areas, in the areas that you want to cover. But then if it does bleed, you know, just like do a tiny touch-up, kind of what I did. What did I do? Here it is. Here's the piece that I did the trim. So I did, you can see some of my brush marks a little bit on the edges, but overall it looks pretty good. Oh, I do need more white here, I could see. So I'm gonna have to come back here with some white again, just to cover it the gray just a little bit, and then come back and touch up the gray. I can see scuffs already here, so I'm not like when I tend to kind of rub against the paper, so this scuff here kind of worries me too. So I just might have to mask everything again, just to do another coat of gray on here, just to get that coverage, I guess is what you call it. Over here too. So yeah, I might just do that. But it won't be a precision mask. It'll just be enough to cover some of this so I can get just a nice coat, an extra coat of gray on here. Okay, so back to this. Let me take this real quick. Okay, I'm just gonna... That's pretty good. Short. Oh, I do actually want to make sure this, the line on this side, I want to make sure it's nice and crisp. So I'm going to roll this, add some more and roll this putty and get a nice clean line, straight line at least. Need a little roller. Collecting all the dust and dirt. Oops. Okay. Okay, now I'm just gonna go over the edges with a sculpting tool. Just getting the edges. Again, this is one of the easiest pieces. I just have to do kind of like a, just get, cover the edges around this piece and then add saran wrap. The really nice thing is saran wrap sticks to this thing very well and also easily peels off too. So win-win in a sense on using this museum putty stuff. So originally I saw online somebody was suggesting silly putty, and I tried that, and the silly putty, it does not stick well enough to do this type of job. It tends, since it doesn't stick well, there was a lot of bleeding. Oh, I'm like, wow, my line is so crooked here. And move this up a little bit, because I noticed I was like so off up here. Let me see, start over here and come back. Sorry, just humming to myself now. Okay, so I'm just gonna bring this up because I noticed I was like a little too far down. I have like a crooked line. I'm gonna make sure this. These lines meet. So what? I'm gonna go close my garage door real quick. It's getting a little cold. One sec. Okay. Okay, almost done here. Just trying to make sure it's sealed in. The edges are like sealed in enough. So I'll try to prevent as much paint bleeding as possible. Okay, so now I'm just gonna add the saran wrap all around the top part. See how easy the saran wrap just sticks to the thing. And it comes off very easy too. Okay, so I'm just going to add a little masking tape, just top of this real quick, just stick it down any openings, just double check here. Okay, and now this is all masked up. Okay. Should I do the big piece? Let me try one of the guns. I think the gun's another easy piece. Okay. So same thing with the shin piece. So I'm just gonna cover the pink plate here and this one over here. At this here. I wish we cleaned this up better. See some 3D support pieces in there I can't get into. That could just be pipes. Who cares? Should be okay. pinch those together. Okay. I'm gonna do the big side first. And I noticed that it actually comes down a little bit more. So I'm gonna cover the edges a little bit. Create this line across here and come back here. Trying to find that line here is very difficult. Where does it stop and meets? Right about here. So this gun is not too hard. I might just drop on the pelvis. Sounds fun. Start on the pelvis after this, and then I'll do the gun, the second gun after that. Doesn't seem too bad. Too difficult to do. But I am thinking I might end, I don't know, maybe at 9 o'clock today, I'm not too sure, or maybe in the half hour. But I'm having a craving for some Cajun seafood, and the store closes around 10, so I'm gonna try to get some. Sorry if you can't see, this piece is a little too tall for the camera. can never get like curves just right. So I'm gonna have to go in with definitely in this area with a brush and try to get that right curvy line in here. Oh, did I do this area yet? I don't think I did. I don't remember. It kind of looks like it, but I mean, maybe not here. Well, I see some of my kneading, so like I might have gone through here. So I'm gonna fix it now. Yeah, this looks pretty rough here. So now I have to touch it up with just a manual brush. Yeah, definitely gonna be doing a lot of touch-up for this. Okay, so that was pretty easy. I'm just gonna cover this with saran wrap. feel like I should get like the row at Costco's, but it's just so big. So I'm never gonna use it. Sorry. The row at Costco is just a lot, but the plastic film that comes out of it is a lot more. I feel like sturdier than this Glad saran wrap that the Costco one. I guess it's more industrial. Okay, so into that. Just a little bit of tape. I might just get like brown masking tape, it's cheaper. Just so I don't waste money on using it for this, what I'm doing here. And there it is. And then we're just gonna paint all this gray. Okay, on this piece, this is my bad print piece, and I was just testing colors on it. I'll just put this aside. There's some room up there. Okay, so I'm gonna jump onto this one, the pelvis piece. This is a very complicated piece. I do actually want to get in here, the gray in here. I don't know how I'm gonna do that. So I'm gonna have to like do masking here. If I have to mask this piece around here, around there. Okay, so it's gonna be a two-part mask, similar to the gun, but just more complicated. So I'm gonna do I'm gonna cover the big area first. I think I should have enough putty left. Okay. Let's see. Alright. I'm gonna start over here. Just gonna the mask here. So this one's kinda weird how I'm gonna the angle of this. This is just at another angle too. I mean another part, so I have to like do just here, so I have to come back and do that. The corners is a little hard with the putty. I think you get it, but then after you remove it, it didn't really get too well, so I have to go back and brush it in. So see here, it gets complicated. So I want to go up. Let's take a look at the reference, actually. Let's see if I have any good references on this rear part. Let's take a look at the video on the rear. Yeah, that needs to be pink. That's pink. I think this whole panel is pink, actually. Oh, so let me see. holds it. Where is it? There it is. Oh, no, no, no. So, turn it around. His hands are holding it, so I can't see. Oh, where'd it go? Okay, so this... Oh, this panel... Uh-oh. This piece down here is actually... no, that's pink. Pink, pink, okay, pink. This is the white piece. Okay, got it. Yeah, the in-between here is all gray, so... Yeah, so it's gray in here. Pink. This whole panel is pink. Oh, okay, so I was doing it wrong. It was like right in here, actually. Oh, wait. This whole panel is pink. So I was doing... Actually, I was doing it right. So, gotta get this area. Yeah, this part confuses me. I'm not quite sure if it should be pink or gray right here. So if I go up, like so. Because the model is not as accurate as what the official Blizzard one is. So that's what makes it a little bit difficult. Oh, this piece is becoming, it's harder than I thought. Okay, let me just stick this down here. I'm just gonna move it around. I don't know what this color is right here. It might be just white. Or a silver piece right there. So yeah, so this is going to be a two-part mask, because I'm going to leave this gap in here open, exposed, so I can paint gray inside. Oh, what am I doing? Oh. I feel like this should be gray as well. So that's just like three parts to this almost. yeah, this whole piece here should be gray. So I'm gonna try to mask around it. Oh, this is a very, very, very complicated piece. I think this might be my last piece for tonight, depending how I can get finished by 9. Take me another hour to get this one down. So I'm just gonna, I want to get into this crack here, but I don't think I can do that with the, even with the brush. So I'm just gonna cover it. Like so, like this. Here. Here. Okay. Oh. And then I'm gonna cover here. Yeah, for the small areas, I'm just gonna put the putty there instead of using saran wrap. Because it's just easier just to fill it up. And I have enough putty for maybe one or two more pieces, I think. And then I would have to paint and then remove the putty from the other pieces. I'm trying to spread this out as much as I can. Yeah, I'm just gonna cover this. I could do saran wrap here. Possibly. Add some more. I'm gonna do like a block of saran wrap. If I can just get more into this here. Pinch that. Yeah, well, we'll figure that out. Oh, I totally forgot this. Oh boy. Very complicated hip piece. So, try not to join these two. This thing comes in. Oh, this is gonna be very tough. Because what I'm trying to do is slide it in there. I don't know if I can do that with this putty. Because definitely I can get a brush in there. I mean, I could, but it's gonna be very sloppy and get all my other pieces painted the wrong color. Let me see. So I'm just gonna, hopefully I can mold it right. It's already touching, so I can't have that. It's gonna peel from the other side. It's gonna be like a little cheesy string. So what I would do is probably just do this. I don't know if I can get in there. The airbrush. Not let these two touch as much as possible. And get this going in here. Let's see how this goes, I suppose. I'm just gonna cover it. It's like a mess. All right. Now for the precision part, this might take me a whole hour to do. I'm gonna start here first. No, never mind, I'm gonna start over here. Well, I'm gonna bring this up just a little bit. Here. See, this is where I have a hard time trying to figure out. Okay, let's do this. This part's a little weird too. It's gonna come up. I should be. I'll follow this line here. Oh, sorry for you. I get too close to the camera and it gets blurry. See, this is what I'm worried about, is trying to get in there without getting in there. I don't know how to do that. How am I going to do that? Get in there. It's the airbrush. This is going to block the path. Oh, this is going to block it. I need like a very, very thin layer in there. I don't know how I'm gonna achieve that. By just maybe just squeezing this in there. I might just try to, after I airbrush it, go in with a brush since I have it all masked up and just do that before I peel it off. I could get in there with a brush, it'd be great. It's one of those things, like, I kind of wish I did the gray first, I guess. And then lay in the pink. But then again, I'll have this problem of trying to mask that crevice. So, I don't know. Well, we'll have to figure that out when we get there. Okay, now this part here. I'm trying to fix this. Okay, up here. I'm not quite sure what this is. Okay, definitely get this gray first. This white, this part right here is going to be white. So should be a simple mask once I get the gray in there. Okay, so yeah, I thought this worked. Oh, I told you to put that here too. Okay, so I'm gonna just try to squeeze this in here. Stretch that in there. Okay. Wow. I did that pretty quick. Oh, I thought it was gonna take me a whole hour, but it only took me about maybe 20 minutes to do. I think I'm getting better at this. Oh, did I forget up here too? Yeah, I did. Forgot this area. So, maybe another 20 minutes. No, maybe 10 up here. It's not too complex up here. My cricket buddy's back. And start chirping. This is going to be tough. And I have the hand brush at the bottom of this here. Thank you. Yeah, so I might just call it a night after this piece. Almost done here. Just so that I can go get some Cajun crawfish. Some Cajun shrimp and crawfish. Cajun seafood. This up over here. Okay, wow, kind of perfect timing. Like, I'm about done and my full cycle playlist finished. Okay, so kind of lazy to, I'm just gonna try to cover this. No point setting up a saran wrap here. I just see, I foresee a lot of touch-up I'm gonna have to do with the brush on this area, in this piece. But this masking will help give a nice smooth finish when I airbrush it as much as possible. So I press on it, it keeps on moving. So I'm just a little worried about the edges. Okay, that looks pretty good. So next week, we have, I think I barely have enough for this piece. I'm not sure about this piece. But this was pretty easy to do. So what I'll do is, oops, wrong screen. So what I'll do is I will probably paint one of these first, maybe the bigger one. Paint this one first and then let that dry, and then as I paint the other pieces, I will, once this thing completely dries, I will remove the putty and start masking this piece. So these two pieces I'm going to do last because I feel better if I add another coat of pink onto this. These two. And then this one. I'm not quite sure what color this piece right here is, this tip right here. Maybe on the video it'll show. Oh, it's just pink. But I guess in here is a different color as well. A close-up. Oh, it looks like it's pink there. Well, I think it's not even gunmetal. I think in this, the joystick area, it looks like it's silver. It's so hard because the lighting makes it, it changes the color, but I think it's silver. I'm just gonna go with silver. That's what my original one is. Whoops, let me show my screen. Sorry about that. The silver right here. So the whole body piece, that's gonna be like a whole other, I think I'm just gonna do that piece color by color, or I don't know. Let's take a look at the whole body piece real quick. I think this might be done. So the body piece, the main body, is the biggest one. The biggest piece of all. And so what I have to do, this kind of requires all my putty, I guess. So I'm gonna have to go in here with the gray trim. And then the whole interior, I was trying to get the pink in here, but I just can't get my airbrush in there right. So I'm gonna try to paint that as much as possible, and then I'm gonna mask it and then paint in here gray,